Hi, this is Andrew Klein. Today's video demo that we're going to look at is creating a human torso from a polygon edge modeling process. You'll see in preparing this scene file, what I've set up is I have three image planes established. I have a side view, I have a front view, and I've also taken the top view, gone to view, predefined bookmarks, and actually turned this into a back view so I could load in a back image plane as well. These are all images which come from 3D.sk and can be downloaded from their site for a fee. And we're going to use these again to actually create our demo today. Now, one of I think the more important concepts when working with image planes is that they give you a good sense of how the form looks from certain predefined angles, but I don't think they always tell the whole story. In fact, I think starting out with image planes like this could be good for gauging proportions, but oftentimes when doing that, seeing the model from a three-quarters view can sometimes look a little bit off. My preference in cases like this is to come in and actually rough out a base model very simply with primitives that we can then build on top of to extrapolate those forms even further with a finalized polygon shape. So while we're going to be working with our polygons menu mostly today, I am going to actually start out in my surfaces shelf, and I'm going to start working with NURBS spheres to do a lot of this. Now I've created a NURBS sphere in my perspective view, and I hit 3 to make it smooth. I'm going to start out examining this in the front view. I'll do one sort of view at a time. I like to think of this like putting together a sort of rough drawing, as you would start a figure drawing, roughing in the basic sort of circular forms to help get the proportions right. So I'm going to take this sphere, I'm going to scale it up till it hits both sides of the iliac crest of the hips, and right to the bottom as well, where the legs will split off. And I'm going to take my control vertices and start to scale this together and pull upwards. I want to be able to follow the upper side contour of the inguinal ligament, which divides the torso from the leg. And for right now, I'm being very rough. I'm not really caring about symmetry all that much, but I'm trying to get basic shapes into play by trying to follow those contours as best as I can. And when I have it from the front view, well, let me go here into the side view, and you can see how dramatically off something like this appears. I'll turn on the X-ray shaded so you can see through the image a little bit. And I'm going to start to just tweak these forms back till, again, they get roughly where they need to be. Trying to trace the contours of the back of the spine. And I like using NURBS geometry for this because of its inherently curvilinear properties. And so if we check this out now in the perspective view, this is going to be our first shape. It doesn't really look like all that much. But when I start grouping these together, you're going to see that they start to form a full body. Let's get another NURBS sphere. And this time around, we're going to try and rough in the upper body. This will be our rib cage. So I'm going to take my two outside edges and pull them down. Scale these two out a little bit as well. And my upper vertices, which I'm just selecting very briefly, I'm going to continue moving around until I've got them up in the shoulders. And I'll pull my center section down a little bit to flatten it out. That looks like it's roughly tracing the form of the upper abdomen. And then again, we've got to go into the side view and deal with this. Now, since our torso is curved so much, I think it's going to be easier maybe to just come in and start this out with a little bit of a rotate from the beginning. and just moving this again until I've got more general contours in place. Now we're going to develop the breast separately, so I want you to, if you're working with something like this, ignore the shape of the breast and try and produce the shape of the rib cage underneath. We'll try and go down right to the edge of the rib cage that we see here. And there we go. There's yet another sphere. Now it's starting to make a little bit of sense. May get another NURB sphere. We're going to get this one from the back this time, because this is going to allow me to shape in the gluteus maximus and minimus and medius muscles. And let's also go into the X-ray shading mode here. Pulling up each of these forms again until they match as closely as I can the proportions for our form. I'm not even worrying about adding in extra isoparms or anything. I'm just letting these very basic spheres do their work. And let's take a look at this from the side. Obviously, this is well out of place. So we'll pull this back and again trace our forms till they work. And in the perspective view, we might need to do a little bit of tweaking on the inside edge here. I've got one. I might as well duplicate this over to make my second side. So I'm going to go to Modify and choose Freeze Transformations. Modify, reset, and then I'll do an edit, duplicate special, and I'll go to the options box, and duplicate this in a negative axis across the X in scale. And that should get this working. It looks like I've actually moved it over a little bit too far, so let me center my pivot here. I think this form is working pretty nicely. Make yet another sphere. And I'll go into the front view. Again, return this to be X-ray shaded. I'll position these in place for the breast, making sure I've got this oriented correctly. See if I can get this from the front. So we're very, very close to a very good roughed-in form and a good beginning shape for our body. Once we have this again, it's going to be so much easier to start to build our model around this form, because everything else is going to be in place. I'll be able to rotate around this and hopefully see pretty easily our shape. Again, I'll do a modify, freeze, and a reset, and then a duplicate special. And I think from something like this, we'll really be able to get started. I'm going to add a couple more forms in real quick so you can see the finalized version, and we'll jump to that form. So with a little more work, as you see, we've been able to rough in quite a bit of these forms and approximate the body by just stretching and pulling a couple of spheres. Now, the last step that I'm going to take is I'm going to select all of these objects, make a new layer, add these to selected, and reference them out. This way, when I'm modeling on top of it, I won't accidentally select them. And we'll start modeling in the next video.